people, fishtanktv.com, Dustin's Fish Tanks, bringing you a midweek video. Who'd have thought we could do that? I'm so excited. I'm standing here with Rebecca Sell from Food Chain. What's up?
Woo!
I like to say I'm her brother from another mother or something, because I walk in here and I see this first. I walk in the door, Food Chain, you can see the door here. I walk in the door and I see like an aquaponics setup like right out of the gate, which is just like, this is just playtime. I mean, this is just like whatever. So very simple setup. I just want to show, giving me ideas for the greenhouse. Dude, take me around. You're like one year or a little more than a year.
In.
All right. So we're gonna go to the plants and then look back to the fish. So we'll walk this way to the plants. I think maybe.
Yeah.
All right. So this is totally a sick setup. This is on where? What's your location here? What's your address?
6th Street. So we're at West 6th and Jefferson, where they intersect. 501 West 6.
And we're here. She does tours, private tours, individual tours. I'm trying to do some tours in here. I'll bring some fish tank people in here when we do a Lexington thing. So let's talk about the plants. You got these four beds, aquaponics set up. Bring it to us. This bed number one, what do we got?
All right, so bed number one is R&D. So this is where we get to experiment around, see what grows well in here, have some fun playing with varieties. Figuring out what kind of different price points we can hit. Microgreens, herbs, shoots, all kinds of fun things in that room.
Okay.
And then the next three all together collectively are our lettuce farm.
And I just want to show what we're stepping over here. Yeah. Like this is like straight up fish tankness at its best. So, all right, so we got 1, 2, 3, and this is the cash cows, right?
This is the production side. So every week out of this system, we've got an entire bed of lettuce that's coming out. So we have three beds. It's because it takes 3 weeks for those lettuce seedlings to grow from tiny transplant seedling to a fully harvestable head. I guess it's about 35 to 40 pounds of lettuce every week.
How long are these beds again?
They're 40 feet long.
Nice.
They're 4 feet wide because the rafts are made of insulation, just 4 foot by 8 foot insulation. So
perfect.
40 feet is 5 rafts.
Perfect.
So simple math there. And at all times we should have a week old raft or a week old bed, a 2 week old bed, and then a 3 week old bed.
But sometimes things happen.
But we're getting ready to fix those. So.
Yeah, and well, here's the cool part. We're going to talk about education more, but you had some issues where you had too much moisture, and that was the deal with the seedlings. Is that the two-minute version of it?
Too much salt, excuse me. So too little moisture was kind of cutting down on that root development.
Right.
So,
it's all about the root. So she's actually missing a week here, but it's all gravy. So we got the R&D, we got the plants. These harvest once every 3 weeks. They're ready to roll. So these will be coming out Wednesday. But y'all are fish tank people. Let's talk about the fish. You got 6 tubs, and give us a cycle on the tilapia.
Okay, so every month we stock one of our tubs. They're 250 gallons. We stock them with about 80 to 90 little fingerling tilapia. So that's a four.
Let's show them the fish while we're talking here.
Yeah, it's like a 3 to 4 inch little fingerling. And there are 6 tanks because it takes 6 months for that fish to grow out.
6 tanks, 6 months.
Yep.
Oh, we gotta net one of these suckers. Oh, you wanna grab that real quick? I'm not gonna be able to net one of these. I got one. Oh, they're jumping. All right, so this guy is, white one, okay.
Yeah, so he's a little bit small, but he'll make good food in just a couple of weeks.
All right, so he's going out in a week or so or whatever?
Yeah.
All right, so we got him out in a week, and then you got your 6 tubs. So we were discussing this, like, it's all good. We were discussing this, though, about how you have, like, issues, because you had, like, fingerlings. So the problem is like, you're going to raise the fish, sell the fish. We need more fish, right?
So every month we're harvesting, so we got to stock again.
So let's talk about what you got going on here. She came out and checked out the greenhouse, by the way. It was just fun to share with people that get it. So preach on it. So what do we got going on here? This is the...
All right, so this is collectively our hatchery, which is brand new to us. And this is what we're going to do then to basically get 2 birds with 1 stone. We want to teach as many people about the full cycle.
Okay.
So we can already do seed to salad right here in the food chain section. We now want to be able to do fish egg all the way to fish on a plate. So this is where we'll be doing breeding. This is the actual hatchery.
That's where they're getting busy in there. That's it. They're getting 5'1", 120 champagne room.
Exactly. is going to be our sex reversal tank. Basically stress out the fish with temperature and the population becomes skewed male.
Right, and why do we want all males again?
Because we don't want them to actually replicate in our aquaponic system.
Okay.
Because the little fish that they produce are small enough to get through the pipes and then they'll eat the roots.
Gotcha. Okay.
So this will then be making our own supply of baby fry. Those fry will then graduate to our nursery, which is on the back wall. And then in 3 months from the nursery, they'll be big enough to then actually supply our own.
So this is the grow out nursery back here. Dude, this is so cool. So much gallons. I mean, just great. Yeah, and they got these big ass fans by a company called Big Ass Fans. Well, I need to hit them up, sure. So they are, because I need one for the greenhouse. So this is sweet. So then when I come here, how soon do you think we're going to have?
Well,
I'm not trying to put you on the spot, but.
Well, so